Downloading reports from systems is a very common activity I've seen across the world. So let's automate downloading of reports once and for all. As an example, I'm going to go to my Amazon account and then go to analytics part and download the report, which gives me expenses month to date. It's something I do commonly. The manual steps which I perform, I want to eliminate. All that we are going to automate using Power Automate. Power Automate is a part of Office 365. How to install it, I will tell you at the end. When you open this application, you will see new flow. Don't give cryptic names, because when you're learning, you will create many of them and then you'll get confused. Click on Create. Now it'll open the designer window. This window has three parts. Actions, the actual steps we are going to record or perform, and then another window on the right side. We don't need Copilot in this video, so I'm going to close it. There are lots of actions. It literally works with any desktop or browser-based app. We are going to use the browser automation. Now let's look at the steps we need to perform. Sign-in should not be done as a part of automation. So I'm going to go to the browser manually, go to Amazon, and make sure I'm already signed in. Now I'm going to close the browser, come back to Power Automate, and now we will record the steps required for further automation. Click on the recorder and the main window will disappear. A smaller recorder window will come. If you see the word pause, that means it's already in recording mode. The first step we want to perform is click on these three dots or ellipses or more options, and we want a browser. So launch new browser. I'm going to choose Chrome and I'm going to type the URL. Press enter. You'll notice that while you're interacting with the web page, individual item is highlighted in red color and it also tells you what type of object it is. So this is anchor, this is input button, and so on. Now I need to go to business analytics. Of course, you should know where the menus are. Another thing is the step should be deliberate and slower than what we normally perform, because it's trying to record the exact things you do. If you do something ambiguous, it may not work. So I want to go to this so that the menu opens. I'm not clicking here, just taking the mouse cursor. That's called mouse hover. Then I'm going to continue to take the mouse cursor further. Business analytics. Make sure the item which you are interacting is highlighted in red color like this. Also notice the border. See, this is the border. If I move the mouse little, the border may increase. It's still the same item, but it's a bigger border. So if there is a choice between a bigger and smaller border, always use the smallest selection rectangle. Now we have reached the place where the reports are. But this window is overlapping the menu which I want to click on. So this window you can move around. The action of moving this window is not recorded. Now I need to go to report. The report menu opens without clicking. So that's again a hover kind of thing. Then I want to go to orders. Make sure it is having red border. Then click on it. The report is month to date, which is what I want. I don't want to change this. Just go to generate report. Wait for it to get highlighted and then click on it. Now it's giving me a sort of a message warning saying this may take time, which is okay. I'm going to click on the OK button. The report is generating. The report got downloaded and saved in the default location. I've finished my work. All that I need to do is close the browser. So far, we have recorded all the actions. Click on the Done button to stop the recording session. You'll notice that a lot of steps, 10 to be precise, have been recorded. One of the steps is just a comment, start of auto-generated actions. Do we really need that? No. So let's delete. Select and delete. Same thing for the last one. Now, before we do anything else, let's save this. And now what? Let's hope for the best and run it. Just click on the run button. It should start the browser and follow our steps automatically. The exact mouse movement may not be shown to you. It's just automating it, but internally it is doing the job. So it seems to have done the job automatically, but our downloads folder is empty. That means it did not work. Now, why it did not work? If you realize, when the browser window closed, report was still generating. That means after generating the report and closing the window, there has to be some time given. There is an explicit command called wait. I'm going to add a delay of 30 seconds. Make sure it is just before we close the window. And I'm also going to add a delay of 5 seconds after clicking the generate report and clicking on the OK button. I don't have to repeat that process. I can simply copy this, paste it, reposition it, and change the delay from 30 to 5 seconds. And now let's run this and see how it works. I have speeded up the video so that you don't have to wait for the entire thing to repeat. And now it has finished making the report. Let's go to the download folder and see that the CSV file is downloaded. So that's how you automate the process. Next time you want to run it, we don't have to open this whole editor. We can go to the main screen over here and click on the play button. Finally, let's see how to install Power Automate Desktop. First step is to go to a browser, navigate to office.com and log in using your Office 365 ID. Once the home page comes, click on these 9 dots on the top left corner. There you will see Power Automate. In case you don't see it, click on More Apps. Another page will come. Click on All Apps, and now you will get an alphabetical list where you will find Power Automate. In the home page, you may see this Copilot text box as well, but I want to go to Create. In the Create page, top right corner, you will see Install Power Automate Desktop. Download the installer, run the installer, and follow the instructions. In this page, make sure you have selected all the options. Whether to allow Microsoft to collect data is your choice. In the next step, you decide which browser you're going to use and enable extensions. When you click on this icon, it will open the browser, install the extension, and you will have to accept and turn the extension on. Finally, you'll have to sign in again, and then the Power Automate home page will open. So try this out and let me know your feedback as well as comments. If you want me to help your organization in transforming the productivity, do let me know. My email ID is in the description. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.